Hi, and welcome back to Sustainable Teacher. If it is your first time here, my name is Leticia, and I'm glad to meet you. And if you've been here before, I'm happy to see you again. In today's video, we are going to talk about robotic components and how can we classify them, how can they be used. So if this video sounds interesting to you, please subscribe, hit the notification bell, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. In a previous video, we talked about the concept of robotics and robots, and we said that inside the architecture of robots, apart from the motherboard, we have different structures that act as sensors or actuators, and today we will learn about them. So as I told you in that video, I'll leave it in here in case you haven't seen it. We talked that a robot has like three main components: the control unit, which is like the processor, like the mind of the robot, with a motherboard that will receive all the information, analyze it, and give an answer to that stimulus in the environment. And then the object that receive the information are called sensors, and the object that perform that action that has been analyzed by the control unit are called actuators. And just for you to know, we have like two main control systems in control units, like open loop and closed loops. The difference between open loops and closed loops, like the main difference, is that open loops don't have sensors. They just have the motherboard and actuators. And in the closed loops, which are the vast majority of robots, they have, of course, the control unit, sensor, and actuators. So today we are going to focus on these closed loop systems. Usually, if we work on school or like a basic level of robotics, we need a motherboard that can be something similar to this one. There are different pins, different sockets where you can plug your components, and there is a processor and also a place where you can connect a power supply to give energy, because of course this works with electricity. I'm gonna show you five different types of sensors that are commonly used in robots. We have buttons, it's something that you can push, and the motherboard will receive the information if it is or not pushed. Then we have potentiometers, and potentiometers are like a rotary structure that you can rotate, and depending on the position, the intensity of the signal will be higher or lower. It's just like the case of volume, okay? So it's, this is an example. Then we have LDR sensors, which are resistors that check the light intensity in the environment, like in a room. And we use them, for instance, nowadays in computers, in phones, in screens in general, that can adapt to light intensity automatically. Well, it could be a different system, but an LDR sensor can do this. And there is another two type of sensor, which are the infrared sensor and the ultrasound sensor. And they are really similar. They can check if there is an object or not in front of a robot. The difference is that the infrared sensor is simpler, and it can only check if it is or not something, like the absence or presence of an object, and that's it. But the ultrasound sensor can detect absence or presence, and also distance. The things that you can modify the answer depending on if you are close or not to that object. And that's the main difference between the ultrasound sensor and the infrared sensor. On the other hand, we have actuators. Actuators are the ones that perform actions that are sent from the motherboard depending on the environment, on the sensors. Okay, so we have four main types of actuators to learn in this video. And these are, of course, motors. They could be DC motors or servo motors, okay, that we've learned in the previous video. And the things that they are actuators because they move as a consequence, as a signal from the motherboard. And then we have buzzers or bells that can emit sound. Imagine that we are in an elevator and we push a button and we go to the third floor, and once the doors open, it sounds like a ring, like a bell. This is this type of actuators, okay? And finally, another typical examples are LEDs. We talk also about LEDs in a video about electronic components. In case you haven't seen it, I'll leave it here also. And LEDs are diodes that can emit light. So they are not really light bulbs, but they can be used like this in robots. We can use them in different situations. Again, in the example of the elevator, once we push the button, like for the third floor, sometimes there is a light ring around the button that will light. That could be a LED, okay? And finally, there is something important to learn about components also for robotics, mainly for when you have to plug components in a motherboard, because depending on the type of component, you will plug it on one part or the other, but it doesn't depend if they are sensors or actuators. The difference depends on if they are digital or analog components, or they have a digital or analog signal. What's the difference between digital and analog? And this is something that we all understand, but because imagine I have a watch like this, and my watch is digital, right? Like the digital television, the terrestrial digital television. And if I have one of these old watches with hands, and they move depending on the hour, this is an analog watch, right? So that's wrong. The thing is that analog and digital we use this in this sense, but it's not really in robotics related with this. Analog and digital is just the way signals are sent to the motherboard, okay? So a digital signal is a signal that can only have two values, like on and off, or like pushed, not pushed, or like absence, present. And that's it. Those are digital components. They can only send two type of information, or they can only perform two type of actions, like movement or not movement, and that's it. And the other type is analog components. And in this case, in the analog signal, the information that can be sent to or received from the motherboard can have an infinite number of possibilities. It could be like the light intensity, so we can have like low intensity, medium intensity, low medium intensity, medium high intensity, super high intensity. So this is an example of different types of signals that can be sent. In the case of the ultrasound sensor, that detects not only absence of present, this is just digital, but also the distance. You can say it's 1 meter, 2 meters, 3 meters, or centimeters. 1 centimeter, 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters, 4.5 centimeters. So the numbers, the distance can have infinite values, and that is also analog. Okay, so that's the difference: two type of values, two type of answers, or infinite. So if we classify the components that we learn as sensors and actuators depending on this, well, this is a really general classification, but infrared sensor, buttons, LEDs and motors can be understood as digital, because the infrared sensor just detects present, absence, the LED is on or off, the button is pushed or not pushed, and the motors are moving or not. It's true that there are motors that can have different velocities, different speed. In this case, in this special type of motors, they can be considered analog. But if this just like this type of motor in which is just moving or not, we can consider them digital. And in the case of analog components, we have the ultrasound sensor that we already talked about, this, the potentiometer, because we can change the intensity, the light resistance, and also the bell or buzzer, because it can emit different types of sounds, different signals in the end. So that's why it is analog. And that's it for today. I hope that now you understand better which type of components can we find in robots, the difference, the real difference between sensor and actuators, and also digital and analog. And as you can see, both sensors and actuators can be digital and can be analog. They are not all sensors are digital, all actuators are analog. They can be mixed, okay? Leave it in the comments if you ever work with robots or robotic components in class, if you like it, if you don't like it at all, if you have any doubt, if you don't understand the difference between sensors and actuators, or analog and digital components, anything you want to say, leave it in the comments, and of course, see you soon.